Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders is not shy about taking aim at those who attack President Trump or his policies. It's her job to be tough as nails, and she pulls it off very nicely. Many in the White House press pool have found out the hard way that Sanders does not suffer fools well. But when she does call someone out for something, she has facts and logic to back it up all the way. That's why Sarah has lasted so long at this job, and why the majority of people on the Hill respect her. This time, Sarah went after three of the top dogs of the Democratic Party, former President Barack Obama and former Secretaries of State Hillary Clinton and John Kerry. All of them attacked President Trump over his decision to pull out of the Iran nuclear deal. The straws that broke this camel's back included Obama releasing a long-winded statement criticizing Trump's actions, Clinton declaring America's credibility is shot, and Kerry claiming Trump's decision weakens our security, breaks America's word, and isolates us from our European allies. That did it for Sanders. She had had enough. There are few issues more important to the security of the U.S. than the potential spread of nuclear weapons or the potential for even more destructive war in the Middle East. Today's decision to put the JCPOA at risk is a serious mistake. My full statement, https://t.co/4oatsisks/BarackObama@BarackObama, May 8, 2018 trending, Sarah Sanders slaps back hard at former First Lady, your husband signed the law. Sanders demolished all of them with her response, I think based on each of those individuals' lack of success in this entire process on foreign affairs, they would probably be the last three people that we would look to for advice and counsel, and whether or not we had made the right decisions, I think that is an accurate and fair statement. Needless to say, the trio were not happy with that statement. Obama tweeted, there are few issues more important to the security of the U.S. than the potential spread of nuclear weapons or the potential for even more destructive war in the Middle East. Today's decision to put the JCPOA at risk is a serious mistake. That tweet linked to Obama's statement. If the deal falls apart because of Trump's action, Obama warned, we could be hastening the day when we are faced with a choice between living with that threat or going to war to prevent it. Obama's deal guaranteed that scenario, in my opinion. President Trump is left with cleaning up his mess and trying to keep Iran from becoming a menacing nuclear power that puts the entire planet at risk. Pulling out of the Iran nuclear deal is a big mistake. It makes America less safe and less trusted. Iran is now more dangerous. What's Plan B? Anyone who thinks bombing is the answer is woefully misinformed. Hillary Clinton, at Hillary Clinton, May 9, 2018. Clinton's response took three tweets, pulling out of the Iran nuclear deal is a big mistake. It makes America less safe and less trusted. Iran is now more dangerous. What's Plan B? Anyone who thinks bombing is the answer is woefully misinformed. Here's the second one. As Secretary of State, I helped negotiate the crippling international sanctions that brought Iran to the table. It would be much harder a second time, now that our credibility is shot, and finally, the third, it will also be harder to deal with other threats like ballistic missiles and terrorism. Now we have no leverage and Iran is free to do what it wants. All I can say is I am profoundly relieved that President Trump won the last election. John Kerry's response was even worse. Instead of building on unprecedented non-proliferation verification measures, this decision risks throwing them away and dragging the world back to the brink we faced a few years ago. The extent of the damage will depend on what Europe can do to hold the nuclear agreement together, and it will depend on Iran's reaction. All three responses could not possibly be any more wrong. What President Trump is doing with Iran currently seems to be working. He's reinstating sanctions and he's playing hardball with the mullahs. He's also putting his foot down with Europe over this as well. What Obama, Clinton, and Kerry did in regards to Iran had a disastrous effect on our foreign policy. Stephen Walt, who is an acolyte of Obama's and has no love for Israel, even admitted the following concerning Obama's Middle East policies. In particular, Obama and his team mistakenly viewed the Arab Spring as a large-scale, grassroots uprising clamoring for liberal democracy and embraced it too quickly. They also underestimated the ability of violent extremists to exploit power vacuums in failed states and the resilience of authoritarian regimes in places like Syria or Egypt. These misunderstandings led to Obama's disastrous intervention in Libya, his inept diplomatic interference in Yemen, and the premature demand that Assad must go in Syria. As Secretary of State, I helped negotiate the crippling international sanctions that brought Iran to the table. It would be much harder a second time, now that our credibility is shot. Hillary Clinton, at Hillary Clinton, May 9, 2018. When you also take Benghazi into account and the deadly mess that turned into, as well as the encouragement that Putin received as he encroached on Eastern Europe and his handling of Iraq, you begin to get a true feeling for just how badly that part of the world was handled under the Obama presidency. Jeff Jacoby at the Boston Globe had this to say: in his rush to pull U.S. troops out of Iraq and Afghanistan, he created a power vacuum into which terror networks expanded and the Taliban revived. Islamic State's jihadist savagery not only plunged a stabilized Iraq back into shuddering violence but also inspired scores of lethal terrorist attacks in the West. Sarah Sanders hit it out of the park in her assessment of Obama, Clinton, and Kerry. You do not seek counsel from those that got you into this geopolitical foreign affairs mess in the first place.